Hey guys, welcome to Shipwreck Tumbler part two. My first video, or my first tutorial, we did the shiplap portion of this tumbler on a different tumbler. And basically, if you didn't see that tutorial, you want to go back and take a look at that. In a nutshell, what we did is we on a prepped cup, we taped off these sections, then we put some alcohol ink on the spaces that were left on the sections, then we sealed it with Rust-Oleum 2x matte clear, let that dry, removed the tape, then applied the alcohol ink on the vertical panels or slats, I guess, and we created this shiplap look on this tumbler. Then what you want to do is you want to go ahead and seal this. So I've sealed this and I'm ready to go into part two, which is adding the water look. We're going to be using some alcohol inks. I have all Tim Holtz alcohol inks. I have aquamarine. I know my jars are a little messed up there. Alcohol inks can be very messy, so always wear gloves. I have pool and sailboat blue. In addition, we're going to be using pinata white. In my opinion, this is the best white out there. So pinata white. All right, let's go ahead and jump right into it. All right, so I've got the cup on the spinner. I've got actually more epoxy than I need. I have 30 mls, but I've found that for me, I need a lot of epoxy when I'm doing water with alcohol inks. Some people put a nice thin layer and they put on their alcohol inks and it just does it perfectly. I'm not that person. For some reason, I need a lot of epoxy to keep the motion going because I have a tendency to overwork things. I can't edit myself. I can never leave things alone. So having a little extra epoxy actually helps me a little bit. So the first thing that I wanted to talk about after the epoxy was safety, epoxy safety equipment. So obviously we wear our gloves and we try not to get the epoxy on us, but I also wear a respirator mask, and this thing is big. It's huge. I don't know if you are going to be able to see the whole thing, but it's basically like a gas mask looking thing. And the reason I wear this is because of the epoxy vapors. I actually worked with epoxy and was making tumblers for about 6 to 8 months, and I never had a problem. And then all of a sudden, one day I woke up and I had just finished a huge order, and I woke up with itchy eyes. By about 3 or 4 hours later, my eyes were so swollen and so red, I looked like Mrs. Farkas from the Eddie Murphy Dr. Dolittle movie. So if you've never seen that, or if you know who I'm talking about, it was bad. Since then, I wear my respirator mask, and I also make sure that my craft area is very well ventilated. I've got some fans and the windows open, and I make sure it's very well ventilated. So I'm going to go ahead and put on my mask. It makes me sound muffled, like I'm, you know, Darth Vader, but I'd rather do that than have those itchy, swollen eyes. And by the way, I had to go get a shot for it to actually go away. They put me on steroids, but it didn't work, so they had to give me a shot to put, take care of it. So yes, I wear the mask. Okay, hopefully you can hear me. I'm speaking loudly. First thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put on the epoxy. So again, I'm gonna put on a pretty thick layer
I need it. Hats off to all those people that can do their alcohol inks and their water scenes with only a little bit. You guys are far better at it than me. I need a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and work that up. And we're gonna go ahead and do the whole cup. Let's make sure we get epoxy everywhere. Now I've had a couple of people ask, well, if we're only gonna do the bottom part with the water, why do we have to epoxy the whole cup? Well, the reason is, at least for me, I mean, people can do what they want. I mean, there's really no rules in this. You can do what you want. But for me, I could never get that. If I had an extra layer of epoxy only halfway on, I couldn't get it to look right, no matter how many layers I put on. So it's just as easy to go ahead and put the epoxy on the full cup. That way you know how many layers of epoxy you have on there. There's no, like, you know, spots where this epoxy ends and then another whole layer begins. It's just easier. I can't see any reason why you wouldn't just go ahead and epoxy the whole cup. All right. Make sure you don't forget the bottom. Make sure you get epoxy everywhere on the cup. I'm gonna go ahead and add more. All right. That is a nice thick layer. Hopefully this will help me not to overthink things and just let the alcohol ink do what it does, because it really has a mind of its own. All right. Now, I have very few bubbles in here because I used an epoxy mixer. It's really nice. It mixes it with two little stainless steel, I don't know what you call them, just like two little stainless steel things that sit inside the cup. And as the cup rotates, those stainless steel stir things, stir up the epoxy, and it comes out virtually with zero bubbles. I'll let it turn a little bit to start to level it out. Epoxy is self-leveling, so that's nice. You can put it on a nice thick coat and it kind of levels out on its own. And while it's turning, I will hit it with a torch just to make sure if there are any of those little micro bubbles, and go ahead and get those out. And with the torch, you just want to kind of hit it and pop those bubbles. You're not trying to heat up the epoxy here. All you're trying to do is get the CO2 to pop those bubbles. It's science, people. CO2 pops the bubbles. Heat can pop them too, but the CO2 really gives it a good pop. And sometimes you hit it with these torches and there's bubbles in there that pop that you have no idea you even had. Okay. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started with the alcohol inks. And when you're dealing with water, I don't know if you can see this, the ocean is very deep on the bottom, so we're gonna go darker to lighter. And then even at the top, there might be a little bit of green in with the white. So that's what my plan is. So I'm going to start out with the nice deep. one of the two, and hopefully we won't hit that stage. Oops. All right, see, I've got a little drop of it up here. As it comes around, I'm gonna try and move that down. And don't be shy about adding some more. Spin just a little bit, see what happens, see where we might need to add some more color. Like I said, alcohol ink does have a mind of its own. You can overwork it, but so far it's looking good. I'm going to probably hit it a little bit there. Darker color again. Again, the colors, add what you want. A little bit more of the waves up here with the lighter color. And you can put the white and then drop the colors right in the middle, or vice versa. Put the colors down and drop the white in the middle. I'm going to go ahead and leave it alone and let it do its thing. It's looking pretty good. I'll probably, after it spins for a little bit, just add a little bit more heat on it and see if I can't get those kind of waves to crash a little bit more. But that's it. That's how you get the alcohol ink on there. All right, I'm going to go ahead and go. Thanks for joining me. I hope if you have any questions, feel free to put them down in the comments and I'll see if I can answer them. I'm certainly no expert at this. A lot of it is trial and error, but the most important thing is to at least try it. So I hope you guys give this a try, and I'll talk to you later. Thanks again. Bye, guys.